anyone seen Zordon?
Hey guys and gals, I'm here with a video. Today it is on the Power Rangers Lightning Collection Wave 7 Dino Thunder Red, along with Wave 8's Dino Thunder Blue. I think these guys look really good together. I've had him for some time. I think I found him in a GameStop, and I haven't seen him since. It wasn't until I got this guy, I was like, hey, let's cover them together. They're essentially the same figure. The helmets are different, and their suits are just the slightest hue different in terms of color. I have not seen Dino Thunder yet. It's on my list. Either check out or watch the Sentai. I'm not entirely sure yet, but I really like the suits these guys have. They have a slight Mindmorph feel in that the red is the Tyrannosaurus Ranger, and I really, really do dig how his helmet looks. And the blue is the Triceratops. As I said, I found this guy in a GameStop. Haven't seen him since. I found this guy in a Target once. There were like two or three of them. And since then, I have not seen any more of them. Like with the other Lightning Collection figures, you do want to see these in person so you can pick out the best ones. Mine, I got to pick from it because some of them had kind of sloppy paints along the visor. And I've seen pictures online where this entire horn was not painted on someone's figure. But if you cannot find these in retail, EntertainEarth.com is one that I always suggest checking out. They've got most Lightning Collection either in stock or restocking soon, at least the last time I checked. I just know every store near me has just a ravaged Power Rangers section. It's very depressing to see. So overall, these figures look really good. I like the overall paint detailings. There are some things missing, like yes, their morphers aren't painted as we've kind of come to expect. You'll notice that once you get to the accessories, hey, stop that. We're not going to do that now. These guys are one wave apart, and yet we're losing the white accents from the gloves that Connor has. Ethan does not have it. We're going to have a lot more of those comparisons coming up. But overall, these guys, I think, look really good, especially if you have Dino Thunder white. I mean, the team's almost done. Unless I'm wrong, we just need yellow and black, and we'll have the full Dino Thunder team. I like the suits a lot more than I really thought I would. So if you own any Lightning Collection figure, you kind of know what to expect in terms of articulation. I'm going to use blue because he photographs a little bit better. This guy just glows. I'm not sure if it's coming through as well on video, but like on my camera, he looks like he's translucent plastic. That's the best way to describe it. Blue really helps kind of balance everything out. But articulation out the wazoo. The head, of course, is on a ball joint, so you have all those nice little movements. You have an added hinge, so you can look up, you can look down. You have this kind of ball jointed ab crunch that I really do like. It does rotate, and it's got a slight kind of ratchet, it feels like. It might just be just it fitting into its certain position, but it feels like there's a ratchet in there of some kind. He does have that T-joint that I never really utilize. I'm glad it's there for those that are interested, but I've never had a reason to use it. It does click, though. You have the shoulders. They have full rotation. He does have the butterfly joint, so nice and poseable there. The arms swing out pretty far. Rotation above the bicep, a double hinge double. They do still have the pegs in their arms. I know Hasbro is slowly moving towards the pinless articulation. Lightning Collection's got pins everywhere, and it's okay. So yeah, double hinge, really nice. The wrists do have rotation because the hands peg in, and they have an added hinge, which works best for this kind of hand. Some of the hands don't work as well. This, you kind of have them do like a little stop kind of thing. You get onto the legs, they go forward, they go back just a little bit, swing out to the sides, rotates above the thigh, double hinge knees, although one likes to go a lot quicker than the other. Boots can rotate. You get onto the ankles, they have ratchets going forward just a little bit. They can go really far back if you really want to break his ankle, and you have kind of the rocker joints. So, and this thing, if you own a single Lightning Collection figure, you kind of know what the articulation is like. You know what you're getting yourself into. I still wish we could have some kind of system in place where you could have the arms go down by their sides. I don't like this kind of outward pose, and you kind of have to manipulate the arms and do kind of weird things just to bring them down to their sides. I don't like it. That does not look good at all. But I will say, I am glad that we still have the slightly kind of matte painting for the suits and just the really glossy helmets. That's just something I've always loved about this line, and I will continue loving it until they stop doing it. When it comes to their accessories, obviously you got hands. They have the exact same set of hands. So you're going to have one set that these are actually the same sculpt as far as I can tell. They're slightly trigger hands, so they can hold the Thundermax blaster and say whichever you want. But you can just see having this one holding the sword as long as it did has opened it up so much, whereas that's how it usually looks. The fingers on mine are a little more pliable than the other ones, so that's great. And when you go down to the others, as I should with blue, you have this kind of, I wouldn't say it's like a casting hand, or like, you know, just something. You got that hand, and then you have this kind of almost an open gripping hand. So they have the exact same hands between the two of them. I forget which they come with, but if you want to switch the hands out, I mean, it's just grip it, you pull it, and then you take this one here. We're gonna go crazy. There you go. They just peg right in. But it is still just disappointing that one wave apart, and we're already losing the slightest of accents. We don't have the white anymore. We, of course, get their civilian heads. And I will say, Ethan, from the few pictures I've looked at just for reference, I feel like his is really good. I feel like it works nicely. The helmets, they are ball joints, so just give a nice little pop. And there he is holding his helmet as I tried not to drop it because it took way too long to get him just to hold the helmet. However, Connor's head, I don't like this at all. Again, the few pictures I saw just for comparison, this doesn't look like Connor. This looks like an old man. This looks like Billy after he started aging and they had to go to Aquitara. I don't like this. I'm not sure, maybe the people who like this head, but I feel like this looks like a man in his 30s, as he probably was, pretending to be a teenager, and I don't like it. I really just get that whole, hey, how do you do, fellow kids, vibe from him, and I don't like it. I still feel like Trent has the best overall face sculpt when it comes to the Dino Thunder team, but there's how they all look. Aside from Creepy Magoo here, these guys look great. So, whoop, and there, that's a little better. They also come with their Thundermax sabers/blasters, and again, like, it's weird the decisions they make. So, if you look at Connor's from Wave 7, we have this almost slightly glossy painted light blue that I think looks fine. The barrels are painted gold. There's a little gold tip on the saber, and it's fine. But if you go to Ethan's from Wave 8, they've gone for this almost matte dark blue that just looks a little thicker, a little gloopier. The barrels aren't painted. I really like that lighter blue a lot more. But when you also go to the saber itself, it carries on. We had the lighter blue for Connor, the darker blue for Ethan, and that little gold is missing. So I don't know why they keep changing things up. We have very little detail to begin with, and they're just like, the gold's too much. Take it out. We have them. You can, of course, store them in their holsters if you like. I'm going to go ahead and put, you know what? I'm actually going to, I'm going to have Connor hold his. Fits in his holster. And if you want to have them hold it in their hands, give me a second. It fits in just like that, and it looks hunky-dory. So there, we'll just have you just there. And let's go ahead and give Connor the sword. Again, the most basic of poses. But you can see how they look. I feel like the saber should be a little bit longer, but maybe not. We do have effect pieces for their weapons, and I gotta hand it to them. This one, I'm like 95% sure this is a brand new piece. If it came with a previous figure, I don't own that figure, so I don't know. But it just fits, just kind of thread the blade through it. And it's a really good flaming piece. I like it. I really do. I don't really display these with my figures, but it's an option. And when I got to this one, initially I was kind of let down, because when you hold your hand, it looks very similar to effect pieces that we've keep getting over and over and over and over again. However, it is a new sculpt. As far as I can tell, it looks entirely new. I don't know if this could have come with the previous figure. I looked through my little accessories box. I didn't see anything. I like the little touch of little glittery bits. I'm not sure how well those are going to show on camera. But for this, it fits onto the tip of the Thundermax, and you can have this kind of effect piece going. I would have liked if we could have had something that was more tied into the blaster, because we have, you know, two bladed rangers with bladed energy effects, but I feel like at that point, I'm just really nitpicking. Let's go ahead and get rid of all of these. You stand there. And that wasn't enough. Let's go ahead and take that off as well. We also get their signature weapons. Stay. For Connor, we have the Tyranno Staff that is... like, I get that the weapons don't have all the paint detailings we expect. I totally get it. There's no way they would put in the whole diamond pattern all along the accessories. But they didn't even paint the Tyrannosaurus tip. Like, that's disappointing. But you can have him holding it in various ways. The most basic, of course, is just have him holding it behind his back, because you want to hide the fact he's missing all the white diamonds. And of course, with Ethan, you do have his Tricera shield. And I think this looks really good. Upon first glance, it looks like how it's supposed to. It wasn't until I compared pictures I realized this wasn't the yellow eyes. It's missing either white or yellow detailings along the side bits. I think they're white. So even for this big honking piece, we're missing stuff. When it comes to him holding it, your best bet, my opinion, is to have this kind of hand that I mentioned earlier. You can have him holding it with this open hand for his right side, if that is what you're into. But I find this just so much easier. It's got a clip on the back and an open part, so you can just slide his fingers on through. Make sure you get it up high enough so it fits where it's supposed to. And you can just have him hold his shield. And again, the most boring pose I could possibly do. But you get the idea of how it looks. It's a really good accessory. And it's got a little feature that I'm hoping means at some point we'll get a new version of the staff. You can have the central horn extended like it's supposed to be. If you want to have it in the Z-Rex Blaster configuration, it does collapse in. And I feel like, why would they include that if they don't plan to have these connect at all? If you go to the staff, there is no hinge. It's not going to collapse on itself. But there is a slight... you can almost hook it in place, and I think this is supposed to like wrap around the top. So maybe at some point they'll give us a version of this. It's going to be a two-pack. They're going to give us a two-pack that has this folded up so you can have the full effect. But maybe at some point we'll get that. But it's interesting that they took the steps to have this being a separate piece that you could extend and retract as if you could form the Z-Rex Blaster. I really don't know why they would have done that unless there's some future idea they'd have. But that is really it. I think I've talked more than I really should have for these two guys. I'm going to give him his staff back. That's not a bad look. And why not?
Let's go ahead and give Ethan his little shield. He doesn't want to be left out.
Speaking of not wanting to be left out, I just like how these guys all look together. I think these look really great. I'm eager to see them do black and yellow just to round this whole team off. So. As I said before, these guys should be out there in retail. I've seen them literally one time each. You can try EntertainmentEarth.com. I have a link in the description down below. Try your other online retailers. I just like Entertainment Earth, personally. I'm an affiliate, so I get a slight commission if you buy something through my links. Obviously, if you're a Den of Thunder fan, this would look great in your collection. Even if you're not, even if you're someone who's never seen Den of Thunder, I think these suits look really good. I love their accessories. We get some nice big shields and big staffs. That's great. The paint detailing is missing, but we kind of expect that at this point. I don't want to say these will stand out in your collection because most teams have red and blue Rangers, so they're kind of all going to blend together. If you want to see them, how the Morpher looks up a little up close, I really didn't really show that off too much, but I think they look really good. I like them. I want to go back and add some little paint detailing, just make them pop a little bit better. But thank you for making it this far, guys and gals. I certainly do appreciate it. If you like this video and you want to see more, I got things up on the top. You can subscribe. I got two of my previous videos, and I got a Patreon and YouTube membership down below that can unlock some bonus goodies for you. I hope y'all have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care.